The days before Christmas. Grandpa jumped up out of bed, silently stepped over me. I opened my eyes, saw a dark silhouette go out the door. Loincloth catching the wind, getting caught in the screen door. Grandpa yelling shit with an Indian accent. He opened the screen door quickly, then came the yelling. Grandma got up. Mom and Sister Lou got up. The door was wide open. Moon shining brightly made the snow fall in shimmering glow so cold. My uncles and aunts were all standing outside crying, while Grandpa in his loincloth beat up Antelame's drunk husband. The Pueblo nights were long and cold, cliff walls of snow piled in between mud wall alleys with small icy footpaths on either side. Hip came home from the army on furlough, tall shaved head pushing the thin native body into a different world. Learned to drink in Virginia, learned to be a radio operator, wrote his wife and children from Hawaii where he was stationed. He brought back the first phonograph to the Pueblo, and he played music from Hawaii. He called it hula ne, hula music. He grabbed the towel, wrapped it around his waist, and wiggled his hips, made his children and us laugh. Several nights before Christmas bonfires, he brought Grandma and Grandpa presents. All his children wore bright Hawaiian shirts to the Christmas pageant. We were all jealous. They were all in town buying groceries and gifts the days before Christmas feasts. Lemay, he said. You take the kids back home. I'll be back in an hour. I'm going to talk to my friends. You better not drink, Auntie Lemay said. She hugged him, then got into Jose Torres' taxi. Stuffed 8 kids into his station wagon. Auntie LeMay rolled down the foggy window and saw him go into the La Fonda bar, a place she knew well. Many times she had to get him out of there. Uncle Hip drunk to the maximum, terrorizing us and his family who lived next door to us. Auntie LeMay married to an alcoholic. But we didn't know what that word meant. That was our reality. In the middle of the night, he would howl like a wolf on top of the village houses, kicking up moonlight dust, dancing back and forth like some evil spirit, banging the door and yelling, acting like he was on some American army base, radioing his wife through the window. LeMay! LeMay! Come in, LeMay 10-4! LeMay! LeMay! Let me in, homo! That was nothing new. We grew up with that next to us. And many of us at the Pueblo knew about that life. You couldn't keep anything a secret. And we weren't trying to. Everyone had our same experiences in different parts of the Indian Pueblo. Learn to read. Learn to write. Learn to speak English. Learn to drive. Go to the army. Learn to drink. Learn to kill. Learn to fight. Learn to hit. That night, she started crying. He started pushing around his kids. I heard all this, sleeping next to my mom. And the glow of the fire, this would not be the last. Hell's reservation dogs would howl not this night only, but many more. A few nights before Christmas, Grandpa beat up Auntie LeMay's husband. Old Grandpa beat Auntie LeMay's husband up. My aunts and uncles crying. Grandpa choked their daddy, their military pop. Tied him up to the drying racks to sober up in the cold and for all to see in the morning. You know, I don't remember seeing him the days before Christmas, but on Christmas I saw him dancing the deer dance. I noticed his blue swollen wrists where Grandpa tied him up, his moist deerskin over his thin native body, keeping time with the ancient ceremonial drum. Black Eyes Clown came and carried him off back to the Kiva. Indian, non-Indian, hunter, army, drinking, ceremony, spiritual, drunk, kill, dance, reality, dream. Like some mean project, put this and that in a flask, mix it up, boil it up, the psychological physics of the gods and goddesses, and given a good drink to the conquered modern native to infiltrate the old native structure of hope. Given a good drink on the days before Christmas to Mr. Lujan. On one Christmas day, many, many years ago, what nerve of the gods, a wicked Christmas present for Auntie LeMay. A scar across the top of her lip, a wicked Christmas present for Auntie LeMay, forever to remain. On the days before Christmas.